Hello and welcome to the Dead Days series on corruption in the state of Victoria in Australia. Considering the recent public arrest of comedian journalist Friendly Geordie and his good friend in Sydney by the so-called counter-terrorism fixated unit in New South Wales, also with the Dead Days documentary almost complete, it appears to be a prudent moment for a short video about the Victorian Fixated Threat Assessment Centre, referred to also as the VFTAC, and this is the first of several currently in production. These are the first six paragraphs of affidavit for an order to impose condition of bail dated 14th day of February 2019, prepared, filed, sworn and tendered as evidence by Detective Hannah Murnane of the Victorian Fixated Threat Assessment Centre.
Paragraph 1. In March 2018, the Victorian Fixated Threat Assessment Centre, herein referred to as VFTAC, commenced operation with the intention to combat lone actor terrorist and grievance-fueled violence attacks and to keep the community safe. VFTAC is a joint Victoria Police and Forensic Air staffed unit within Counter-Terrorism Command. Specialist police and forensic and mental health experts collaborate to target high-risk persons with complex needs, who pose a serious threat to the Victorian community, to intervene early, and prevent violence.
So, what we have here is a so-called counter-terrorism unit making an application to impose a condition of bail to ban a member of the community from contacting all members of the Parliament of Victoria. This application is based on the false statement, dated 1 January 2019, of former Victorian State Attorney General Martin Pakula, about an incident at 121 Exhibition Street in Melbourne on the 27th of December 2018, where Martin Pakula screamed an obscenity in public while assaulting a disability pensioner. Since the 14th of December 2017, Victoria Police, Forensic Care Victoria, Corrections Victoria, Victoria Legal Aid, Magistrates Court of Victoria, and certainly the purported Counter-Terrorism Police, via a previous wrongful imprisonment on the 13th of October 2017, all had, on the public record, a copy of an autism diagnosis from an experienced and well-known psychiatrist. This diagnosis, however, was concealed for some period of time from the subject of the report. Next, to paragraph 2.
Paragraph 2. VFTAC aims to reduce any risk posed by these individuals, to themselves, their families, and the wider community. Lone actors belong to the group called fixated, in other words, people who exhibit an obsession or preoccupation with a person or a cause, which they pursue to an irrational degree. These individuals typically may have come to the attention of counter-terrorism police and other agencies because they may exhibit extremist ideology, show indicators of being radicalized, or have extreme grievances.
The only problem with this story so far is a piece of evidence. That piece of evidence being the CCTV footage of the incident involving Member of Parliament Martin Pakula at 121 Exhibition Street in Melbourne on the 27th of December 2018. That CCTV footage, referred to in the sworn affidavit of Detective Hannah Murnane, was misrepresented by Detective Murnane, and she refused to include the evidence with her application and affidavit. Detective Hannah Murnane has been served with several County Court of Victoria subpoenas to provide the CCTV footage, however OPP prosecutors and the courts have managed for 2 years to have it excluded from physical evidence for the defence without having to obtain a court order to do so. And on to paragraph 3 of this affidavit in application to impose a condition of bail to ban a member of public from contacting all members of the Parliament of Victoria.
Paragraph 3. VTAC provides a structured and coordinated approach to respond to serious threats of violence posed by people with complex needs that could result in terrorism or other extreme violence. The centre also helps such people get the care they need, and by doing so, decreases the risk they might pose to the community, themselves, and those around them.
So, with the full knowledge that Martin Pakula had lied about the incident, the VFTAC filed an application in the County Court of Victoria in Melbourne containing misrepresentations, prevarications, and a false statement of the former Attorney General Martin Pakula, and they don't have a problem with that.
If you're good at something, never do it for free.
Nor does it seem, Judge Lisa Hannan, who was forced to dismiss the application begrudgingly. Judge Hannan, amidst obiter dictum, which the transcripts show had nothing to do with the submissions, affidavits and evidence before the court, for example talk about conspiracy theories, even though Judge Hannan had denied the respondent his right to question Detective Hannah Murnane on the very subject, under cross-examination, and despite it being paragraph 93 that in the words of Detective Murnane, the defendant, held bizarre conspiracy theories. Well, It appears that this matter has proven the joke that the only difference between a conspiracy theory and the truth is a period of about 3 years. Now, if you are thinking this is all quite concerning, I can tell you that you haven't heard anything yet, and we haven't even reached the fourth paragraph. Well, here it is. It is a ripper, a smoking gun in the scheme of things. Sting, appearing to be an entirely appropriate word in this context.
4. The respondent Rohan Michael Brown, herein referred to as the respondent, was referred to VFTAC in March 2018, due to the large number of concerning emails he sent to various members of the Victorian State Parliament, members of the judiciary, senior state public servants, senior members of Corrections Victoria and members of Victoria Police, including members of Victoria Police Command. The emails aired a number of grievances, and named individual police members, using terms which his presenter chooses not to say on air. However, you can see them in the transcript before you. His main grievance relates to claims he was the subject of an aggravated kidnapping and unlawful imprisonment by police on the third day of June 2016. It appears the respondent believes that the actions of police on this day, and since this time, were unlawful, as he was held for 12 days without charge.
So, we are talking about emails about a wrongful imprisonment and Section 181 of the Crimes Act 1958 aiding and abetting by police, which members of Parliament had been advised about and were refusing to acknowledge. Let us examine that. To make things remarkably simple, we will start with the smoking gun. At the end of paragraph 4, it appears the respondent believes that the actions of police on this day and since this time were unlawful, as he was held for 12 days without charge. Now, who better to explain how simple it is to demonstrate the corruption, aiding abetting, concealment, and possibly large conspiracy to defeat the administrative course of public justice than the so-called defendant himself? Keeping in mind that at the time, on the 3rd of June 2016, there were no laws within the entire Commonwealth of Australia that allowed for the detainment without charge of a subject of the Commonwealth of Australia. This was a wrongful imprisonment, that is an undisputable fact. Survive just staying alive or carrying the rest of the tribe. Waiting for the day to arrive, struggling dies and I'll be doing way, way. Rohan Michael Brown is a 51-year-old father of an 18-year-old son. He currently lives in the eastern suburbs of Melbourne while attempting to bring these matters to justice. Like many in the state of Victoria, Rohan plans to leave the state the first chance he gets. Rohan is a business consultant in the area of business process improvement and business marketing. In his spare time, he likes to make films, mountain bike, have a surf, skate, or any number of ways to get the adrenaline going. We spoke with Rohan about the VFTAC and this application to ban him from contacting all members of Parliament, as well as the several times he has been falsely charged and wrongfully imprisoned. Rohan claims that police documents in his possession, which are easily accessible by police and likewise supported by court records, just as easily accessible by officers of the courts, is evidence that he has been falsely charged and wrongfully imprisoned several times. This is what Rohan had to say.
One, I've never been charged with making a false statement. However, I have in fact made this exact claim of an aggravated kidnapping and wrongful imprisonment several times in numerous unchallenged affidavits. Two, it would take even the most defective investigator around 5 minutes to confirm that I was charged on the 15th of June 2016, 12 days after I was locked up on the 3rd of June 2016. Three, verification of this fact would be just as easy using court records available to every registrar and judicial officer in the state. The fact is the Victoria Fixated Threat Assessment Centre was deployed by Police Minister Lisa Neville at the cost of $30 million to taxpayers for political purposes and to quieten the victims of Police Department of Justice and Parliament of Victoria crimes. This is a conspiracy to defeat the course of public justice. Section 181 of the Crimes Act 1958, aiding and abetting, and Section 257 of the Crimes Act 1958, reprisals. Martin McCullough, Lisa Neville, defectives from the VFTAC, John Kane, John Saunders, they should all be in prison.
Wow. What a story. This short account is alarming to say the least, however, this is only a very small part of the story. The complete VFTAC exposé will be released soon. Stay tuned to the www.deaddays.com.au website for updates. All of the documents referred to within this video will be available on the Dead Days website in the coming days. Thanks for watching. Keep sending us your stories of dealing with the fixated units throughout Australia or any other police and government corruption experiences you have had. In the meantime, and until we see you again, we wish you all the very best, stay vigilant, stay positive, and we will see you soon for the next installment of the Dead Days series. Dead Days, a practice of corruption.
I'm all line before I dial up. How they claiming they on top and I'm a mile up. I had them all line before I dial up. How they claiming they on top and I'm a mile up. I know the walls closing in, but don't you dare give up now. Poe believed in me, pull up through some bucks down. Tied till the valet pull the truck round. Push the line after we drew it, it's just us now.
This was a true crime video production by A1 Now Productions for FARQ Media, telling the facts and true accounts which the mainstream media refused to discuss. If you have an idea for a production, get in touch with us on the www.deaddays.com.au website. A1 Now Productions and FARQ Media are 100% Australian run and owned, alternative media and true crime specialists. If you would like to support these productions and the further exposing of corruption in the state of Victoria, Commonwealth of Australia or around the world, check out www.deaddays.com.au to find out ways to get involved.
I had them all line before I dial up. How they claiming they on top and I'm a mile up. Boy, that death like the Amsterdam. Well, my accountant and minus, my family found out too and didn't like it. You're not in the salon, what Dale said and I thought he was biased. Then I got a Venmo that said copy the finest. Before my foolishness settled in, recorded a whole tape before we got to Berlin. This close to giving up and now never again. Don't overlook the work and come expecting to win. In the end, my word never put nothing over the squad. Got it right up under their nose, gentrified a facade. Off the cliff with broken wings, I'm aware of the odds. Enough faith for us all, I'm the one for the job. Most days, catching sun rays, baby, look like the front page. Overthinking what they might say, have it your way. Yeah, the biggest threat is something they never seen. Dial it up, patch me into the screen. I had them all line before I dial up. How they claiming they on top and I'm a mile up. I had them all line before I dial up. How they claiming they on top and I'm a mile up.